English Short and Senior 120 word per minute June 1993. Strut. Mr. Speaker, I rise to move that the annual financial statement of the Tamil Nadu Electricity Board laid on the table of the House be taken up for consideration as required under the Electricity Supply Act. The Tamil Nadu Electricity Board submitted these financial statements to government for approval. These statements are open to discussion in the state legislature but are not subject to vote. The board will of course take into consideration any comments made on the statement in the state legislature. A statement indicating the action taken on the comments made during the discussions last year has been circulated to the honorable members separately. I hope they have gone through it. The Tamil Nadu Electricity Board is the biggest public sector undertaking in the state with about 1 lakh employees on rolls. It has been a pioneer organization in the field of power and power development over the past many years. The progress of the state to a large extent depends on the growth and performance of the electricity board and the useful services it renders. In Tamil Nadu, the demand for power has gradually been increasing and it is more than the power actually available for consumption. Thanks to the rise in industrial activities and the energization of agricultural pump sets, the load growth has been very great. Today, Tamil Nadu has an installed capacity of more than 2000 megawatts. The state continues to give top priority to agricultural production. The energy consumption in this sector is well over 25% of the total consumption, which is the highest in the country. The power development in this state has been sustained over the years. The phase of progress in the last decade can be seen from the charts circulated to the honorable members. It may be seen therefrom that there has been nearly a two-fold increase in installed capacity, peak demand energy generation with nearly 3 times increase in the number of villages electrified and the pumps connected. A tripartite meeting attended by the electricity board chairman, workers' representatives and the Union Minister for Energy and Labour has suggested a 10-point guideline for associating workers' representative with the operational activities of the power systems in the country. These guidelines are under consideration of the board. I want to remove the fear in the minds of future consumers. Frequent power shortage experienced by us is only temporary. Then need not be any apprehension on the part of the enterprising industrialist to the availability of adequate power for farmers and factories. The government and the board are taking all steps possible in this regard to meet the ever-increasing power demand and improve the power position. With the multifarious uses of electricity and the changes that have taken place over the years with the introduction and adoption of this effective tool, we have to plan a more liberal and intelligent use of energy. The time has now come to have a second look at our own attitudes and revise them wherever necessary. The concept of conservation of energy is gaining public support all over the world. It will be in the fitness of things that this new concept is universally accepted and supported by all concerned in the larger interest of the state over which all of us are keen. I have enumerated the major tasks before the board and the resources needed for achieving them. I trust that this house will offer its recommendations to help the board serve the people much better and with the motto of consumer satisfaction and contented labor. Letter dated 6th September 1991 from Jupiter Insurance Company, Bombay to Mr. S. Ashok, 41 Tilak Road, Pune. Dear Sir, thank you for your letter of the first instant regarding the insurance of your personal luggage while touring in the continent. We have already sent you a proposal form which we would like you to complete and return to us duly signed with the necessary particulars asked for. We remind you that it is essential for all details to be accurately furnished as this form is the basis of the contract. For a 2 months tour, we are willing to grant cover at the rate of 20%. It is to be understood that this race doesn't include production in certain distributed areas. If, however, you would like to spend on appreciable time in private houses, we would be prepared to consider a partial refund of premium. We would draw your attention to the conditions given in the proposal form with regard to the coverage of electronic articles. These are not protected under these conditions and require a special policy, for which we will be pleased to quote on hearing further details of your requirements in this connection. We would, however, add that clothing worn by the person is covered against all risk. Please return the proposal form duly filled in and sign it at your earliest convenience to avoid any delay. Thanking you, yours faithfully.